With the garden winding down and taking up less of my time, this is the perfect time of year to catch up on my reading. And today I thought I'd do something a little different and let you know about a book I recently finished reading. One of my goals as a gardener is to do my best to try to figure out which products and practices really work and which ones don't. And this interest led me to Jeff Gillman and Maleah Maynard's book, Decoding Gardening Advice, The Science Behind the 100 Most Common Recommendations. As the title suggests, the authors put together a list of what they believe to be the 100 most commonly made gardening recommendations. Drawing on the latest scientific research, as well as Gillman's expertise as a horticulturist and Maynard's as a master gardener, the authors categorized each recommendation as either good advice, advice that's debatable, or advice that's just wrong. Even if you're new to gardening, you're probably familiar with many of the recommendations covered in this book, and you may be surprised at how many of them end up in the debatable or just wrong categories. For example, from the following list of 10 recommendations, 4 are considered to be correct, 3 debatable, and 3 wrong. Number 1, create an environment favorable to earthworms. 2, use mycorrhizae to promote healthy plant growth. 3, use pine needles to make soil acidic. 4, use vermicompost to improve garden soil. 5, avoid watering overhead to control plant diseases. 6, apply compost tea to help enrich soil. 7, add lime to soil to raise pH. 8, always mulch gardens. 9, add sand to clay soil to improve drainage. And 10, water deeply and infrequently to encourage a strong root system. If you'd like to venture a guess at how the authors categorize these recommendations, or share how you'd categorize them, please do so in a comment below. Given that the authors only considered 4 of these recommendations to be clearly good advice, don't be surprised if this book challenges some of your views. It certainly challenged many of mine. But I think this is a good thing. Only if I'm open to having my views challenged and questioned will I be able to learn and grow. In the near future, I hope to make a series of videos exploring various gardening products and practices from an evidence-based perspective, much like the video Stephen Legary and I made recently on pine needles. Many of these topics will be inspired by this book and others by my own curiosity. So I definitely recommend Decoding Gardening Advice. If you're interested in learning more about the science behind common gardening recommendations, this book is a great place to start. My hope is that by continuing to use effective products and practices, while avoiding ineffective ones, I'll save money and time while still getting great results. Well, that's all for now. Thank you very much for watching. And until next time, remember, you can change the world 1 yard at a time.